Hello everyone, this is Marin for Lanfon. Today we join a cute bear family at the arcade game. They're playing at the claw machine and it looks like they're pretty skilled at grabbing stuffed bears. As always, let's check out the supplies I used. Your claw song, Snow Much Fun for the four bears, then Sweet Den for the baby bears, Holiday Helpers for the Tiny Bear, the Waving Pool Tab die set, the Snowy Backdrop, the Biggest Die from Large Stitch Rectangle Stackables, and the Strip Die from Picket Fence. So here we have my stamped images. I cut them all using the coordinating dies and used my alcohol markers to color everything. The white ones are graphite brush markers and the black ones are spectrum noir markers. And I wanted my little scene to be super fun and bright, so I used rainbow colors. For the background, I went with two papers, a rainbow paper from the Really Rainbow paper pack, and also a light blue panel on top. I may have used the snowy backdrop to cut that blue panel. The name suggests that it's a winter-themed die, but if you use colorful papers or papers that are just not winter-related, you definitely can get a fun look for birthday cards, for example. So I layered and attached both panels using liquid glue, trimmed off the excess of paper off-screen, and I also created a very simple floor that I placed at the bottom of my panel. I also placed the machine and a bear next to it to get a general idea of the scene, but most of all because I wanted to see where I needed to place the double slot die. I didn't use the stencil included in the waving pull tab die set because the bear was too low, so I just eyeballed it. So I taped the die on the panel and sent it to my die cutting machine. And once the double slots were cut, I took my T-ruler and aligned it with the middle of the slots and drew a pencil mark at the top of my panel. I took the notch die and placed it at the top. I lined up the middle of it with the pencil mark and made sure that the long sides of the die were up against the top edge of the panel. Next, I cut the pull tab out of the same blue cardstock. And you can see that the hole in this tab was too high, so I customized it to fit my design. I lined up the pull tab on my panel and marked the center between the slots. I pierced a hole on that pencil mark and then I assembled the elements. I started by placing the arms on my desk with the X marks at the top. Next, I took a small brad from my stash and put it into the customized hole at the back of the pull tab. And then I put the arms on the brad, making sure to keep the X marks at the top. And I opened the brad to keep those arms in place. I bent those pieces a little bit and then put them into the slots at the back of my panel. But as I said, it's customized, so it wasn't perfect at the first try and the arms wasn't moving enough to me. So I tried with a hole above the first one, but I still wasn't happy with the result. So I tried with a hole below the first one and it was much better. That means that even if you think that you just messed up a card or a project, it doesn't necessarily mean throwing it out. Well, sometimes you just cannot do anything else, but most of the time a mistake is fixable just by trying in a different way or hiding it with an image or a decorative piece, or maybe just by leaving the mistake just as is. Because in the end, the most important thing is the heart and love you put in a project that will make someone smile. So while I was being all philosophical, I cut a sleeve that I attached at the top of the pull tab, right below those two tiny tabs. And I stuck a second one a little bit lower. I like to do this just to make sure that the tab stays very straight. Next, I attached the remaining piece of background at the very top of the pull tab on the front. And then I stuck the floor using double-sided sticky tape. And before moving on to my favorite part of the video, I attached my panel on a mermaid card base using two layers of foam tape all around the tab but not touching it. And so my favorite part, I finally assembled and attached all my cute images on my panel using a combination of foam tape for the largest pieces, as well as foam squares and glue dots. Thank you. Once everything was glued in place, I white heat embossed my sentiment on black cardstock. It reads, "Have a very fun birthday," and I trimmed it into slim banners that I attached below the notch. And speaking of the notch, I cut the arrow out of chili paper cardstock and stuck it to totally complete my card. And that's it, all done, and these are very cute and happy bears we have here. Looks like they're going to clear out the machine. I hope you like this new card. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!